What's up, guys? Jedi Warrior back again with another LEGO Star Wars review. I've been doing the microfighter reviews, and this time I think I'm going to try to do three of them, because these three make sense. We have the Imperial Shuttle, the AT-AT, and the Star Destroyer microfighters here. I'll start with the Imperial Shuttle. I think this one looks really good overall, although the rear fin looks kind of small to me. In the front, you have the buildup for what is usually like the windscreen area of the shuttle, which I think looks really cool, although I've never seen a large one. The two guns in the front can actually swing out a little bit, but not much, not much if you have the wings down. New wings can raise all the way up for the parked position and drop for flight position, although if it's dropped, you cannot stand it like that, although I think it will stand up on the wingtips. But they don't include a small stand of any kind for you to pose it like this, which I didn't expect them to in a microfighter. On the wingtips, you have a pair of stutchers, one on each, like normal, press down on the gray bits and say goodbye to those studs forever. The cockpit area is actually, when you put your figure in the cockpit area, he sticks out a fair bit. But if you raise the wings like it's landed and put him in there, you can't really see him that much. This microfighter does also use the windscreen technique that they've been doing with the single cheese slope in the front. I will note this. Although the box calls it Krennic's Imperial Shuttle, it does not include a figure of Director Krennic. It just includes a figure of a regular Imperial officer. That's why I didn't call it Krennic's Imperial Shuttle. But overall, as a person who could not afford the bigger Imperial Shuttle, I think this works. Now for the AT-AT, this is one of my first few microfighters, and I have liked it ever since I got it. I've always thought this was cool. Just like the last one, the figure sticks out of it an unusual bit. You have spring-loaded missiles as the guns on the main body area, although mine are currently missing. The head can move up and down. It's got about 3 ratchets worth of motion on that ratchet hinge. It's got 2 stationary guns on the front and 2 guns on the side that can swing out, although I haven't used this in a while, so mine are a little stiff. I think the head looks good, although it looks a little small compared to the rest of the body. Now the legs are what impressed me. They're hooked on by Technic pins. Let me push mine all the way in. They can move at 2 joints. The ankle joint and the hip joint, I guess. So you can get this into some interesting walking poses. But the hard part is going to be lining up the feet and then setting it down and having them not reset to normal. But I always thought this microfighter was really fun. It includes a standard Imperial pilot as its minifigure, nothing special there. Whoops. Hold on. There we go. And last but not least is the Imperial Star Destroyer. This one looks kind of plain to me. You have your center cockpit seat, which is weird. It comes with the Star Destroyer captain, which I believe was an exclusive figure, but not one I cared about too much. You have three engines on the back using two disc pieces. Actually, I think it's... No, it's only one disc piece in a cylinder. Or one disc piece in a plate. You have the bridge tire that sticks up. And you have two spring-loaded shooters... Or spring-loaded missiles, and, or I say spring-loaded, it's flick-fire missiles, my bad. I will note that in the front, they did not finish off the triangular design. They just left the front flat. And I'm pretty certain that's not accurate. But what was funny is in the spare parts for the set, there are two white 1x1 G-slopes, and you can finish that off yourself, which is what I did. I will note that your pilot doesn't even get a control panel. My dad building this noted that they had you build it from the ground up, standing on its back, and then they had you lay it down and then put the bridge tower on there. He has built a bunch of these. And that one he specifically noticed was different. I thought that was interesting. But I didn't have a lot to say about this microfighter. So that's it for now. Peace out.